Do you consider yourself an expert? Then you need to know this curve. Of course I know what's that curve. It's the one that we've been talking about for the past few months. It's the one that we have to flatten out. So there was this guy called MacArthur Wheeler. He was watching TV one day and he saw in a documentary that someone used lemon juice as invisible ink. And he got a great idea. He put lemon juice on his face and he went to rob a bank. Not one bank, two banks. Of course, a while later, the police went knocking his door. He couldn't believe what happened. He was like, how is this possible? I was wearing the invisible juice. The police was like, huh? Yeah. And I'm sure you as well, you are like, what? So the act of this genius sparked the curiosity of two people, Professor David Dunning and Justin Kruger. And they found that there is a disparity between how much you think you know versus how much you really know. Welcome to the Dunning-Kruger Effect. So how does it look, that curve? Okay, let's draw it here. On one axis, you have confidence. On the other axis, you have competence or actual knowledge. From known to expert. In the middle, you have average competence. Okay, I'm gonna explain this one very quickly and very simple. Now, do you remember when you got your first diploma, high school or whatever? You felt like you're gonna conquer the world. At least I did. Now, that feeling, you know, and you're ready for any job and you are looking and now I'm a sound engineer. That moment, you are here. Mount stupid. That means that your confidence is way higher than what you actually can do. And then you get your first job. And what happened? You are a sound engineer. You have a beautiful diploma. Okay, here's the console. Live gig, festival, 12 bands, big stuff. And what happened? You realize that you don't know as much as you thought you did. So now you start to move from the Mount Stupid down the hill. And you arrive to this point where you think, wait, this is tricky. That feeling is just going to get worse from there on. The more exposed you are to the job, the more you realize that there is so much to learn. You have so much road to cover until you arrive to the valley of despair. That is the center valley. That is where the average people is, where your confidence is at the minimum and your knowledge is average. And this is a crucial moment in everybody's career. And at that point, most people make a decision either to leave and pursue something else, something that they find or they see, they feel like is easier, or continue pushing. Once you pass a point, from there, everything is easier. Once you pass a point, suddenly you see like, oh, you're getting the hang of this. Things are coming together. Things are happening for you. And then that confidence starts to be rebuilt as you are exposed to experience and as you are learning more about your career. And there is a long way until you get to this point. Once you pass that moment and you actually decide to stay and continue doing what you want to do, your passion, you're gonna go up the hill, no? Yeah. So you're gonna go up the hill through the slope of enlightenment. What happened? That you're gonna learn more and you're gonna learn more. You're gonna get more excited and things are gonna go. Now your confidence is not gonna be like before, that you were to the edge of cocky and to the edge of being arrogant. Now you actually settle down and you're just gonna learn and you're gonna keep growing until you become an expert. You become that grand master of sound engineering, which it takes forever, by the way. Now, remember this, realizing how little you know is the first step to actually know stuff. The important bit is that the sooner you leave that mount, the quicker you're gonna arrive to the point of enlightenment, the quicker you're gonna pass through that valley of despair and you're gonna start to become the person you will be, or the person or improve the person you are right now. Once you pass that value of despair, everything gets easier from there. Let's go to the conclusions. Let's see what we got. One, if you're new in the industry, please understand, like everything else in life, there is a learning curve. And the frustration part is gonna be there. And the reward part and the satisfaction part, it will be there too. Two, don't be afraid of asking anybody for advice. A little bit of feedback, a little bit of moral support. Three, and last, if you are an expert, look back and remember that you were once that person that is coming, following your steps. Help them. Help everybody behind you. Don't keep any secrets to you. There is no such a thing as trade secret or professional trinket or whatever it is. That it doesn't exist nowadays. When you feel on that valley of despair, when you feel like you cannot do it, you cannot, this cannot, I can't, and you are about to throw the towel, just look around you very well, every person in your industry. You're going to see that there is people already doing what you want to do, that already know what you want to know, already getting the rewards that you want to have. If other people did it, you can do it. There's no difference. Don't give up. Keep trying. This industry is one of the most beautiful industries there can be. And finally, remember that there is always someone that knows more than you. Always. Okay, this is all for today. See you next week.